What are you talking about? How could you get a sample of perfected artificial skin?
Why don't you take a look at this? We found this in the rubble of Queen's Hospital.
Is that random? Random's a... Snatcher?
Random!
Oh, an acquaintance of yours?
But I'd say that.
He's a Snatcher?
That term isn't exactly accurate. This Bioroid was constructed by my father without my knowledge. He modeled it after me in my youth. He built it right here in this facility.
Well, that's too random. That,
he programmed it to destroy Snatchers. Huh. This Bioroid caused me serious difficulties.
Good.
It's designed and built far better than my Snatchers. The machine itself thought it was human. My father input memories for it all the way back to childhood. Those two were apparently mine. Haven't you yet realized? Random Hajil is Elijah Modner spelled backwards.
Yeah, hours ago.
How like my father, silly old man. He did virtually overnight what I could not do in 40 years of effort. Furthermore, he makes a Bioroid so perfect, even the Bioroid itself believes itself to be real. What's more, the cells of the skin he developed are self-replicating. Once in place, no further transplants or culturing is necessary.
Is he dead?
Its main and locomotive systems are completely shut down. It's just scrap now. But the artificial skin is being kept alive. This we need. With this, we can move to phase two of our plan, a full-scale infiltration of the world's major nations.
No, that's all right. I think I'll pass on that.
The summit's already over. You'll never succeed.
What does the summit matter? Nothing holds us back now that we have this perfect skin. We can go anywhere we want, and there will be no way to tell us apart. I will have free control over the world. Nothing will be able to stop me. Politics and free thought will no longer have any meaning. My will alone will decide the course of human history.
You egomaniac. Do you think you can snatch the entire population?
There's a fully automated Snatcher factory under the Kremlin. Even as we speak, scores of new Snatchers are being born.
But no matter how hard you try, you won't be able to snatch the people's heart and soul. What do you hope to gain from this anyway?
Jamie, the human race is composed of fools. But I'm different. I will be its savior. Indeed, not just of mankind, but of all life on the planet.
Oh, brother.
I'm afraid that won't be possible.
Metal!
Metal!
In 10 minutes, this church will be struck by a phased particle beam. I am guiding the beam from the attack satellite using GPS and 15 navigational satellites. The beam cannot miss. Everything in a 2 to 3 kilometer radius from me will be destroyed.
Stop this foolishness now.
Never.
I will not have my research destroyed by some souped-up pocket calculator.
Metal, what happened at the summit?
The delegates, worried about the Snatcher menace, voted unanimously to allow the use of nuclear weapons on the city. The military is presently imposing a quarantine on Neo Kobe.
What? Do they intend to kill everybody?
The populace is in a state of panic. However, they have agreed to lift the quarantine if this church is struck by the phase particle beam. This is our last chance. I will handle things here. Gillian, Jamie, you two must flee.
Yep.
You insignificant mass of metal. You'll never...
One move and I detonate. Gillian, run!
He's gonna detonate
metal,
anyway.
This is crazy!
We can't let a single Snatcher get out of here. And this new artificial skin has to be destroyed as well.
I will not allow some... talking scrap pile to get away with this. If you were the aiming point for the beam, then I'll just have you thrown out of here. Grab this little one and take him out of here.
Uh-oh. shooting segment?
Metal!
Cowardly little robot.
You always were a real pain in the butt.
Random?
What's that?
Haha.
What? How did... You're supposed to be deactivated.
Yeah, really.
I don't go down that easy, old man.
Stop this foolish...
Shut up! Let's try to make our final moments peaceful, shall we?
Where are the snatchers?
You, snatchers? You touch the little guy and the old man's head comes off.
Random!
I've always hated being used. Why don't you watch the final act with me?
Gillian, you only have 5 minutes. The turbo cycle is just outside on standby. Use that to flee.
Let me go. I'm Elijah Modner.
Don't let him go.
I'm your original.
I don't care if I'm an original or a copy or what. You and I are gonna die right here. If we both die, there won't be a copy anymore now, will there?
The stupid logic of a simpleton, of a machine.
Whatever it is, it's my will!
Machines have no will. Machines cannot sacrifice themselves.
We'll see about that.
Watch him.
You have 4 minutes. You must go. And don't forget to take care of the factory under the Kremlin.
Time to go.
Stop!
Gillian, even if these memories in my head are fiction...
Yeah, I know what you mean. Our memories of our time together are all too real, Random.
Gillian, you become one hell of a junker.
Gillian, it has been most recreational being your partner.
Oh, Metal.
Recreational?
If you can, try to pick up the pieces for me, okay? Like we did for Little John.
Little John? Oh. Okay, Metal.
His memory.
Hurry! You only have 3 minutes.
Thanks. Thanks, you two. Jamie, come on.
Yeah, we just keep talking.
No! Don't let her go! No!
We left.
You pathetic old fool! You don't even know how to love someone!
You stupid machine! What is that idiotic grin supposed to mean?
He's not grinning.
By snatching you, I'm finally gonna get my real self back!
Random. There's less than 1 minute to go. Thanks to you, everything will be fine.
You don't owe me any thanks. Sorry to get you involved in such a big job. You did great. You're a hell of a junker.
Three, two, one, here it comes!
Later, kid!
Well, that's sad. Boom.
Going, aren't you?
Where?
It's our responsibility, too. Besides, if I go to Moscow, I may get some of my memory back.
All right.
And if that happens, I'll be able to love you even more than I do now. Wait for me. I want to be with you, but first I've got to destroy this terrible factory of theirs. Jamie, when I get back, let's try living together again. What do you say?
Be waiting for you too.
Katrina! Mika! You're here too?
You better be happy, Buster, with all these beautiful women seeing you off.
I'm happy you came. Let me introduce my wife.
Jamie Seed. I suppose it's a little odd introducing myself a second time, though.
What do you mean? You've never met them before, have you?
What are you talking about, Gillian? We're good friends.
Huh?
What?
Since when?
It's the first time I've met her in person, but I've spoken with her on the video phone a lot of times.
What? Have you guys been talking about me behind my back?
We had a date with Mika. Jamie. Gillian says, I'm really sorry for all the worry I've caused you. By the time I return, I'll probably have my memory back. Don't worry. I promise to make you happy. I'm in luck, right? You might be a bit lonely for a while, but I'll be back soon. Hang in there. Katrina. This kid has had such a rough time. She lost almost everything practically overnight. I just couldn't stand to leave such a cute kid all by herself. Yeah. I know your motivations weren't always, I don't know what to say. Honorable? I'm going to memorize every detail of Katrina's lovely face so I don't forget it. Katrina says, Gillian, would you stop that? I feel like you're undressing me with your eyes. Well, you're probably right. And Mika? She's done a really great job. I owe her a lot of thanks. Don't worry, Mika. This is one job I won't mess up. Talk to Mika. Trying to learn more about you was what got our relationship started, Mika says. Before I knew it, we really became close, didn't we? Our relationship has gone beyond just being friends. Gillian says, beyond just friends? That sounds pretty good to me. Oh, don't be stupid, Gillian. You have a warped mind sometimes, you know. Be right back, guys. Okay. Which one did I talk to? Mika? Oh. Katrina. I was telling Mika about how lonely it was being home alone all the time, and she told me that Jamie was always worried about me. So I gave her a video phone call. Katrina was telling Mika. With even Alice gone, I was really lonely. Katrina, Gillian says. Katrina says, they're both so easy to talk to. It's like I've got two real sisters now. They're just like family to me now. Oh, now I can talk to Jamie. While you're away, I hope it's okay for Jamie to come and live with me. Yeah, I have no problem with that at all. It will shorten my commute as well, so I'll be killing two birds with one stone. Great, Katrina says. I'm so happy. It's so nice to have somebody else living in the house with me. She's still saying more stuff. Okay. Jamie. I'm so tired of living alone. Maybe I'll ask Katrina if I can move in with her in the near future. I think you guys have been over that. I feel almost as if I've got a new little sister. It's really wonderful. Katrina is such a cheerful and sweet kid.
So have they finalized what they're going to do about Junker operations? I suppose this will end up being our last mission, huh?
Well, originally they were planning on disbanding the team, but now they've decided to keep us in business.
So that means...
That's right. We've been designated as one of the government's special police divisions. That puts us above the regular cops.
Sweet.
So the government has decided that crime by machines poses a bigger threat than crime by humans from here on out, huh?
They've chosen the new chief, too. So when you get back, you'll get to meet the new head honcho.
Well, it's comforting to know I've got a place I can come back to.
Have a safe trip, Second Lieutenant Seed. I'm a second lieutenant as well, so let's try to work well together when you get back. I don't think that'll be a problem, Mika. What? I'm a second lieutenant? How come my rank is even lower than what I had in the army, huh?
Whatever you do, just come home safe, okay?
Mm-hmm.
When you get back from this job, you still have a dinner date to keep with me, you know.
Don't worry. I won't forget my promises to either of you. Oops, oh, almost forgot. Of course, I'll want to spend some private moments with my wife, too, huh? What's wrong, Jamie?
Harry and I will be waiting for you to get home.
That's Harry's hat.
Oh, God.
We can do it this time, Gillian.
She just still doesn't
Not
know.
Not some fake couple like before, but with love and trust.
I know, Jamie.
Take care, Gillian.
I'll see you, Jamie.
Wait! Wait for me!
She still doesn't know about Harry, though.
Please!
You? Metal?
Yes, sir!
He turned into a Sega CD.
To work with, so this is just a temporary body. Just call me Metal Gear. Sega CD for now.
Oh, God.
So they found your memory chip in one piece, eh?
Random protected it from the blast of the beam.
Random, huh? Wait
Uh-oh.
A second. I've heard that sneeze somewhere before.
Napoleon.
Really? I didn't hear anything. Anyway, I want to know if you'll take me with you. Please, Gillian, please take me with you.
Hurry up and get on board, partner.
Yes, sir, Gillian.
History. Suspicion has always bred conflict.
True.
The real conflict, though, resides in people's hearts.
I guess so.
This conflict has just begun.
Oh. Credits. So what do you guys think? I love it. It's a freaking awesome game. Stay tuned for after the credits because I have some bonus numbers to check on the video phone. So I'm just going to have to find a save where I can actually use Metal Gear to call somebody. So stay tuned for that. It's an awesome game. It's one of my favorite games now. Guess so. I've played quite a lot of games for the first time for this channel. And every once in a while, well, I've played a lot of great games, but every once in a while I come across a real gem that's just wow, like you have no idea it was going to be this good. This is one of those. This and Planescape Torment definitely stick out for me. Ouchie. Okay, bonus time. Video phone. Now, I found these numbers on a walkthrough. Actually, this one I might have misdialed. This is what we call the love line, and they told me to dial this number for real love. Told me the number was not in service. Recorded message. Hi, I'm Stella the Stegosaur. Thanks for calling. Will you be my friend? Okay. Next, this is for Inamura. I don't know where these numbers are found, guys. It's just at the end of the walkthrough. 443723. Hi, this is Mr. Inamura, the subprogrammer. I used to breed cancer cells before I started programming. Okay, and this is for a Jeremy. In all caps, I think I smell a rat in my house, baby. I believe he's got just two legs, yeah. Chai, would you turn that down, please? Okay. Moshi moshi. Barosatin desu. Huh? What? Gillian says. Oh, hello? You speak English? No, I live in Japan. I speak Japanese. What language was that? That was Japanese. I don't get it. Well, technically you're speaking Japanese in the world of the game, but it's translated into English so that everyone can understand you. I don't have any idea what the hell you're talking about. By the way, was that Buddy guy? Yeah, that's right. You're into Buddy too, huh? I don't know who that is. You know, Gillian, you're a lucky guy. You get to do all these exciting things, surrounded by beautiful women who flirt with you constantly. Yeah, well, you know how it is. Some people got it. And all I do is sit in front of this terminal writing funny sexy stuff for you to do. Ow! Kiwi, don't bite! There, take that. Ha! That'll teach you. Don't hurt her, Chai says. It's amazing she survived this long. I'll say. She should be dead. She's over 55 years old. By the way, she's not the hurt one. Look, I'm bleeding. Ooh, that's a bad one. Yes, it is strange that she's lived this long. I guess it's her positive mental outlook. Gillian says, look, sorry, I gotta run now. I'm conducting an investigation. Yeah, well, I know how it turns out. Huh? What? Forget it. Good luck, Junker. What if I call that number again? Do we get something different? Really don't mind if you sit this one out. Hello? Oh, hold on a minute, okay? Sorry about that. Hello? Who is this? I don't know. You called me. Listen, this is Gillian Seed from the Junker Agency. Who is this? It's Gillian Seed from the Junker Agency, and that's what you just told me. Mph. What number is this? How many guesses? Listen here, I want to talk to Jeremy. Well, why didn't you say so? Why, you... Jeremy says, who are you? Why are you harassing my wife? Oh, it's you, Gillian. What do you want? Do you still have my copy of Crest of a Knave? Yeah, but... Ouch! Hey, you little monster! Get out of there! Yow! Kiwi! You okay? Yeah, just my stupid cat again. Listen, call me later. Wondering how many different results we get. There's more numbers after this too. In all caps, the day is necessary every now and then for souls to move on, giving life back again. Hello, Jeremy says. Oh, what's up, Gillian? I just realized, your cat, Kiwi, you said she's over 50 years old. Yeah, so? How's her physical condition? Oh, Kiwi's in great shape. Never better. Damn strong cat. What about her behavior? Does she go out much? Very rarely, but sometimes she goes out at night. Why? Any strange smells? Well, yeah. Kind of rottenish. So we give her baths a lot. She's got some kind of chronic skin problem. Get out of the house now. That's no cat. It's a snatcher. Actually, snatchers pretty much limited to the shapes they can morph themselves into. Gillian, you're tripping. It's my Kiwi-chan. Ay, Kiwi, no. Ah, my eyes. Dear God in heaven, my eyes. She's taking my eyes. Roar. Out, vile jelly. Kiwi, drop that. Kiwi, no. Mommy loves you. Eh. We better get over there, Metal. Sorry, Gillian. This game is not programmed for that scene. We'll have to forget about it and pretend that nothing happened. Okay, Metal. Sounds good to me. Who ever heard of Pussy Snatchers anyway? What? So I'm guessing we call now and there's no answer because they're dead. But snatchers can't even inhabit the bodies of children because they're too small. That's how the cat answers. The cat snatcher. The call will not go through. Alright, next number. This is actually, believe it or not, apparently, anyway, Jordan's number. That's right, the computer Jordan. It's a digit shorter, I think, as well. Oh, it's actually still, no. This is Snatcher 911, Jordan says. Yeah, the regulars are... Yeah, it's actually still six digits. This phone call is automatically recorded. Please clearly explain your situation in 30 seconds or less. The computer in Junker HQ will process and respond urgently to your situation. Please speak in a calm, clear voice. Okay, go ahead. Understood and recorded. Huh. Interesting. And this number is for Kushibuchi, if I'm saying that right. I'm now in Honolulu for the marathon. Please leave a message. Okay. Short but sweet. This is for Sasaki? I don't know who these. I'm guessing these, at least some of these, are the developers of the game. I will continue trying to make software that will move you, surprise you, delight, and amaze you. Okay. And this is Togo? Hello, this is Mitsuhiro Togo. Hi, nice to meet you. My family is made up of my daughter and my extremely tough wife, who also serves as our bodyguard. My hobby is constructing IBM PC AT-compatible hardware. Our personal computer is hooked up to a network, but is not open to the public. I am an expert in MS-DOS and Windows. If any questions, please ask. Well, talk to you later. Bye. Gillian says, hey, what are you doing, hanging up like that? Metal Gear says, he seems to be rather self-centered. Ever since that jerk got married, he never goes out anymore. Alright, so we've got some official numbers here. The fire department. This is Neo Kobe Fire Department Emergency Line. Please report the type of emergency, status, location, and damage. This call will be automatically recorded, so please speak in a calm, quiet voice. Metal Gear says, it's very wrong to make a prank call to the fire department. Two more. So then how about a prank call to the police department? Surprised I didn't try this myself. Hello, this is the Neo Kobe City Police Department. Whoa! Gillian, you shouldn't call if you have no reason. Hello? Is something wrong? Metal Gear says, I'm breaking the connection. I'm actually going to try that one more time. Gillian, you have no business calling them for no reason. Okay. Last number. This is the weather. Today's Neo Kobe weather forecast. Today will be clear due to a high-pressure system coming in from the south. But the National Observatorium has reported that the hole in the ozone layer continues to increase in size. Well, that's good news for us. It'll help burn those snatchers up. They recommend that if you're going out of the house, you should liberally apply a thick coating of anti-UV sunscreen. Gillian says, clear day, huh? Metal Gear says the weather is our ally. The increase in ultraviolet rays will limit their movement. We should continue the investigation while this weather holds. Awesome. Let me see something, actually. We can ask him the numbers. Oh, we only have these that show up. All right. Well, thanks so much for watching, guys. I thoroughly enjoy this. Let me know what you guys think of the game, the story, everything. I'd give it... I don't know. I'd give it like an 8 or 8.5. Would be a 9, but for the shooting segments were really annoying. But anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys, and hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. Always, seek adventure.